Hello. First, I just want to say thank you so much for everyone who left a review. It was so sweet. I'm gonna respond to all the emails tonight now that Christmas is over. So yeah, that was so nice. Thank you. I appreciate that. Ah, so cool. So yeah, let's get into it. So I've noticed that with Moon transiting Moon being in Libra and Venus being retrograde in Capricorn, as well as a bunch of other Capricorns, we have a lot of square energy with our Moon in Libra and with all this Capricorn. That relationships, especially having to do with family, but also, of course, love relationships. These two things, there can be a lot of tension, I think, today and tomorrow and the first part of Tuesday. And the key is to just be aware. I think there's a couple of keys. First, I think it's really important to give each other space. With Moon in Libra transit, we all can be a little bit, our boundaries of self and other can get a little challenged, and we can feel like, oh, it's our responsibility to get involved with the situation, or, oh, wow, so-and-so is not being very pleasant, or they're not being very communicative. I don't like that. I'm going to judge that. You know, that Capricorn energy can come in, and the unhealthy part of that Capricorn energy can come in and say, oh, I don't like that, and then try to like get involved. Essentially, all of it kind of comes down to the same stuff. Create really solid, healthy boundaries with the people around you, as much as you might love them, especially with your loved ones, you know, whether romantic or platonic. Our boundaries can get really challenged, and we can start to take things personally or make us feel like we have to fix things or we have to control things or whatever it is. And in reality, we are only responsible for chiefly responsible for our own emotions. Of course, if we're influencing other people's emotions in a negative way, we're responsible for that. We need to make sure that we're not doing that. But ultimately, we need to take our focus away so much from other people and more so focus on our own relationships, our own lives, our own well-being. I think especially because a lot of people are visiting family and whatnot, this theme can come up of stuff going back to childhood. It doesn't matter if you're 40, you're visiting your parents, you're with your siblings, etc. And then all of a sudden certain stuff, maybe jealousy comes up, sibling rivalry, or maybe whatever it might be, these things can arise and can really frustrate us. So it's important to just take care of yourself, get back into your regular routine. When we go visit somebody, we can get out of our routine, especially with the holidays. I mean, it's lovely to have these kind of special days, but we can tend to undermine or even let go of our routines that are really good and really helpful for self-care, whether it's meditation, taking care of hygiene, whatever it is. Just take care of yourself, you know, have that time to yourself. You don't have to be around loved ones all the time. I think that's a common theme that a lot of people are experiencing right now. It's like, no, it's the holidays. We have to be around all the time. And it's like, no, that's not good during any season. And I think especially for today and tomorrow, the first part of Tuesday, there is that Moon and Libra, again, combo, that combo with the Capricorn as well, can get a little challenging. So again, healthy boundaries, it's all good. Let's enjoy this time period, whatever it is that we're experiencing. And I think that's the main thing to focus on for the next couple of days. Again, don't be too quick to judge. Be patient with others. Stand up for yourself as need be. Let the small stuff go. Don't sweat the small stuff. I think that's the best way to handle the next couple of days. Yeah. And one last thing. If you're going through romantic relationship challenges, you don't have to make a decision right away. I think especially for today and the next couple of days, it'll be very difficult to make a solid decision. You'll be weighing things. Oh, how do I have to get other people's perspectives on this? How do I feel about it? What other people think, etc. So don't feel that need to come to some kind of decision. It's these kind of things take time, and we have Venus retrograde until I believe like the first week of February, February 6th or somewhere around there. And then we have the shadow period for that until March, essentially. So take your time, it's all good. We don't have to come to any kind of final conclusion right away, especially over the next couple of days. Infinite love to you, my friends. As always, I'm doing readings, info in the description. Namaste. By the way, I specialize in several different things with astrology, but I love doing relationship readings. I never take an approach of yes or no. It's always, I'm not trying to persuade anyone to be with somebody or to not be with somebody. I feel like that's irresponsible. That's not really the most helpful approach. Also, my job is just to help figure out the pros and cons of the relationship. Every relationship will have both. And by the cons part of that, I mean the challenge. That maybe miscommunication is a challenge, or it could be all kinds of things. So if anybody needs a relationship reading, of course, come during any time, but especially during this time, it'd be a great time to check that out. Bye. Namaste.